In this video, I'm gonna share some editing tips and tricks to make it look and sound like you're incredible in front of the camera, even if you really aren't. If you mess up a lot and stumble over your words when shooting these kinds of videos, or maybe if you can only get out one line at a time, then you're gonna wanna keep watching this video.
You gotta just press record.
Hey, my name is Nolan with Think Media. Now, tip number one is actually gonna be an editing hack that is gonna save you a whole bunch of time when editing these kinds of talking head videos. And then the next four tips are gonna be some editing hacks to show you how to make it look like you are really good at talking in front of the camera, and make it sound like you can just go on forever when in reality you might be doing it line by line. I'm gonna show you how to get around that so that you look and sound great on camera. With all that being said, tip number one is to edit using your audio waveforms. Now, I can't tell you how much time this has saved me. In the past, I used to put my videos into the timeline and just go through, watch it, edit out the clips that were bad, keep all the things that were good. Now, that's still basically the case. You wanna keep the good parts, right? And we wanna get rid of the bad parts or the mess ups. And now that's still my first step when I get into an edit on a YouTube video like this. But using the audio waveforms are actually gonna help you just trim down the entire process and speed it up. Hey guys, I thought I would just jump into Final Cut Pro and really show you my editing process and kind of just get this edit going a little bit so you can see exactly what I do and my method. So instead of talking about it, I just wanted to show you. So right down here, we have this 16 minute, 23 second clip. If I zoom out a little bit, you can see I did this video just in one take and I kind of just would start and stop. And if we look down, you know, I was talking about the waveforms, the audio waveforms. So if we zoom into our clip a little bit, you can see here that we have some audio waveforms. And so these bits right here is when I'm talking. And over here, when these waveforms are really low, that's when nothing's really happening. You know, I'm just kind of getting ready to shoot. And then when I start talking, you can see that these audio waveforms. So that's what that is. In case you did not know, that's what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna show you exactly what I do when I edit these videos. So I'm gonna listen to the first few seconds and this is gonna be my intro.
This video, I'm gonna share some editing tips and tricks with you guys to make it.
So in this video, I'm gonna be, you know, that's what I'm talking about. Okay, so I'm gonna skip forward now to this part.
In this video, I'm gonna share some editing tips and tricks.
I mess up because there's a little pause here. So I start over. But I don't need to listen to the whole thing. That's a waste of time if I listen to the whole thing. I'm actually just gonna skip forward. I probably mess up here. So I'm gonna listen to this part.
If you mess up a lot and stuff.
Okay, so I've moved on and this is exactly what I'm looking for. And so now that I've moved on, I know that this last piece right here and right here, this is my good take. This was a mess up, this was a good take. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that and I'm going to delete. Now what I'm gonna do is the same process. I'm going to start skimming through and find my good take, which is my last take. So let's go ahead and do that.
If you mess up a lot and stumble over your words when shooting, mess up a lot in front. If you mess up a lot and stuff. Hey, my name is Nolan.
Okay, I've moved on because I'm now talking about something else. I'm now saying, hey, my name is Nolan. That's not what I was talking about. So this is my last take right over here. Now, this is probably a mess up, but let's go ahead and just get in there and see exactly what that is. I believe this is a mess up.
Over your words a lot.
Yep. Hey, perfect. I was talking about stumbling over your words and that was me filming this video. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. And so right now, what you're going to see is I have these two clips and they're my good take. Once I get all my good takes, I'll then go in. You'll see there's kind of a long pause right here. Right, that's kind of awkward. You can see my eyes go down. What I do afterwards, once I have all my good takes, that's when I come in. I really refine these jump cuts so that the audio flows and there's not these long pauses. So it's probably something like this.
Really aren't. If you mess up a lot and stuff.
So that, you know, that flows a bit better. And so let's go ahead and just do this one more time for you guys. So I just skim through.
Hey, my name is Nolan Bolt with Think Media now.
All right.
Hey, my name is Nolan Bolt. My name is Nolan Bolt with.
All right, so you see how fast I did that on this one. I messed up quite a few times, but this was my last take. This was my best take. And so now.
Hey, my name is Nolan with Think Media. Now, tip.
So that gives you a little inside scoop as to how I go through and I really quickly trim these 16 minute, you know, videos down into, you know, 7 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever the video ends up being. And that's how I do. I just skim through really quick. I get it done. I get all my good takes together and then I go in and I refine everything. Now this is gonna save you a lot of time because you don't need to watch and listen to all your bad takes. You just want to find that good take. Now, if your good take is not your last take, what I like to do when shooting these videos is I will maybe stop and then I'll say, okay, I'm using the one back, you know, two times ago. And, you know, that is what I do to look into the edit, and then I will see that when I'm editing and I can adjust it from there. But for the most case, literally 95% of the time, it is my last take that's the best take, and it really helps me save a lot of time. Tip number two is using B-roll. Now, using B-roll can cover up your cut. So when you stop talking and you start talking again, or maybe you had a mess up, using B-roll to actually cover up that jump cut is a great way to hide the jump cut. Now, I use this all the time. I use B-roll to cover up those jump cuts, and it makes things go a lot smoother. And then it takes what used to be maybe some segments, and maybe it looked kind of choppy when you watched it back, but when you put B-roll over it, it might look like you're just, and sound like you're just talking forever, and make you seem kind of like a professional talker when in reality you were just doing it in segments. Now, if you're scared of talking to the camera and it's a bit intimidating, then using B-roll over your entire footage could be a really good thing for you to try doing. I've seen a lot of YouTube channels where it's strictly voiceovers, and this allows you to do a voiceover and to read it, and that's a lot easier for a lot of people instead of talking to the camera. So, you know, if you're just getting started, using B-roll, doing a voiceover, this could be a really great way for you to start making YouTube videos, and instead of doing these talking head stuff, just have B-roll over the entire thing. Tip number three is to crop in and crop out. Now, this helps a lot when you're talking and maybe you're doing it in segments, but it looks kind of choppy. Using a crop in or a crop out is going to help make it look like you are talking in one long continuous piece. Now, of course, if you are moving around the room and if you are in different places with your hands or your facial expression, it is going to be a little bit off, but I think this looks a whole lot better than just a direct jump cut. Here's an example. I'm gonna do two lines, and I will start by doing no crop, and then I will do it again with a crop in and crop out, so you guys can kind of see what I'm talking about. Hey, my name is Nolan with Think Media, and today we're gonna be talking about editing tips and tricks. And if you're enjoying this video, make sure to give it a like. Hey, my name is Nolan with Think Media, and today we're gonna be talking about editing tips and tricks. And if you're enjoying this video, make sure to give it a like. So you could see there on the first time when you watched it through, there was no crop in effect, and it looked a little bit choppy. It still wasn't too bad because my voice was kind of the same. I was in the same position, but I think when I cropped in, it just made it look like it was fully one piece, and I cropped in the middle of my sentence. It looked like I did it in one take. Before we get to tip number four and tip number five, if you haven't liked this video yet, well, come on, like the video, comment down below, let us know what video editing software you use. All right, tip number four, I don't use this one as much as my crop in, crop out, or B-roll, but I like to use the flow effect in Final Cut Pro 10. Now, you don't have this effect in iMovie, but if you have Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve, you probably have something similar to this, and it's kind of where it meshes the two frames together. So when you have one clip and the next, it will add in some extra frames to kind of blend them together. And I use this when I don't want to crop in or out, but I want to make it smoother and make it feel like it was one take. The flow effect, you know, depending on the circumstances, can be a really nice tool to have when editing YouTube videos. So to find the flow effect, if you click on this button right here, this is going to open up your transitions. And if you're selected on all, you can just simply search for flow and you're going to find it right here. Now, a really good example of me using it and it kind of blending these two frames together is right here. So I have this clip, and if I go frame by frame, you're going to see it's added some new frames. And right here, this is actually a new frame where it's starting to merge the two together. And right there, it's doing it again. My eye looks a little bit funky because it's kind of merging them together and going into a blink. And now we're into the next clip. And what this allowed me to do was to not crop in or crop out. And because it was kind of a short clip, I didn't want to crop in. And I was, you know, in the same position. And so using this flow effect worked really well right here. And you probably didn't even notice it when you were watching the video. This happened at 55 seconds. Yes. And I'll show you exactly what this looks like right now.
much time this has saved me. In the past, I used to put...
You really can't tell. And that's the really cool thing about the flow effect. You know, it really only works in certain circumstances, but for interviews and certain things where there's not a lot of movement going on, this can be a really good tool to have in your kit if you're using Final Cut Pro.
And tip number five is to stay in the same position. Now this can be, you know, kind of tricky and hard to remember sometimes, but if you stop talking, you want your hands, you want your voice level, you want all those things to be in the same position. So when you do that crop in or crop out or the flow effect, it's going to look a lot better and it's going to be a lot smoother. So that's something I do when recording these videos, is try and stay in the same position when I mess up so that when I cut to the next one or the good take, it all looks very natural. And that goes with your voice level too. If you're talking kind of quietly and then it cuts to you maybe talking super loud, that can kind of throw people off. So try and stay in that same, you know, volume with your voice while recording the video. Now, if you guys do use iMovie, we have a bunch of tutorials and we're going to continue to put out some iMovie tutorials on the channel. And so click on the screen right now to check out that playlist. I'll see you guys in the next video.